Welcome down to Buckenham right here. The runway is
Ken would take great pleasure in standing around for hour after hour, answering make the question.
Everyone knew Ken. There must be someone out there better than me for the task. Then, having mulled it over, I realised I'd been one of his chums since the late 1960s, when we would get water for the crop spraying aeroplanes out of Mrs. Patterson's pit on Shipton Airfield. A couple of months ago, I put my back out, which hurt my left leg so I couldn't drive or fly for a while. And I suddenly realised that whilst my brain was still operating at age 14, the body was saying, once upon a time, well, I'll go on with that later, hang on. Ken had a knack of being in the right place at the right time, or as he would say, the wrong place at the wrong time. Anyway, he managed to land a bunch of those infernal McCulloch target drone engines in the early 60s. They were too straight by name and nature. One compartment weight ratio, but right up there with the politicians for reliability. A summer's evening in 1973, Ken was standing by his two-seater. I think it was a 117. And he says, "Have a ride." So, me being it up for all things, I had a go. Well, I've done some pretty stupid things in my flying career, this was one of the most frightening flights of my life. Having mounted this thing like a horse, we shot up in the air with much thrashing from the infernal McCulloch, screaming, thankfully, behind. No visible means of support, zooming through the Ramusville trees, sitting on a billion knots of very well-renowned balloonists who's come all the way from California.
Because we have flown, we envy no man on earth. Good afternoon, sky lovers. It's a huge privilege to be asked to come here today to remind us all why we so respected Ken Wallis and what he did for men. My dad came out of France at Dunkirk. My generation is acutely aware of what the Ken Wallaces of the world did for our freedom. And to me, it is a tragedy to watch how our freedoms are being taken away by the basket load. All any of us who have been in private or experimental flying, even for quite a short time, we know people who are dead because they killed themselves in the air. People used to write books with titles about the conquest of the air, following the right colors, but we know very well you never conquer the air. At the best, when we're up there, you can strike an uneasy truce, and if you're very careful, get back to the ground.
Thank you, Julian, and I'd finally like to ask Mel, Ken's granddaughter, to come up and say a few words.
I wasn't actually expecting to do this, so I'm not prepared, so forgive me if I stop it. Really, say thank you to everybody for making today possible. It was a bit like Challenge Annika. I gave Matt a call a few weeks ago and said, "I've got an idea, can we do something for Grandpa?" He said, "Yeah, of course we can. We've got a date, 29th of September." And then it went into absolute overload. So thank you, Matt, so much. Old Buckenham Airfield, Jeff, everybody, you've been absolutely brilliant doing this all together. Jerry, Henry, Julian, amazing tribute to Grandpa, and I think he was sort of sat there sort of nodding away thinking, well, you know, he's a very modest man, but it was brilliant. And also thank you to everybody for bringing their aircraft, amazing array of aircraft, autogyros, helicopters, planes. I'm not aeronautical, I couldn't tell you exactly what they are. Cars and vehicles and bikes and boats and a really random mixture of things that actually were totally irrelevant to Grandpa. And he would have loved to have flown in today. Perfect flying weather for Montejaro. Sunny, warm, really windy. He would have shown off big time if he'd been here today. But he's here in spirit. And thank you all for coming today. It's meant a lot to us, the family. And we're very proud of him. We miss him dearly. and I'm sure we all will. So we must never forget the likes of Ken Wallis. Thank you very much.
I'm going to do a white tape there and I'll cross for us if that's what I'm talking about. Oh, look, I'm going to do a dog follow this thing.